Hi friends, so this video is about the low pressure that is present in the Bay of Bengal near the Andaman Sea. Over the past few days, since April 29th, I have been putting up videos about this low pressure. So the low pressure that formed around May 1st has dissipated, and I was telling, there was no cyclone threat, and that came true. Although models were showing cyclones and taking them out in the next run, But we were sticking to the dynamics, and by looking at the dynamics, I was telling that there is no cyclone threat. Okay, so now there is another low pressure that is going to form, and that is likely to form tomorrow, today around May 8th, and it is going to be there at least for next three to four days. So let us see what is the status of this low pressure. Okay. Or how it is going to behave, whether we will see any cyclone or not. So in my last video on May 5th, I had said that low pressure is likely to persist due to active ocean atmospheric interaction, but we had ruled out any cyclone formation because there is not high convective power. MGO is also not favorable, and SST anomalies are also not very high. And we had said that there is no threat for our Indian coast. Okay, even if the low sustains, it will go to Bangladesh or Myanmar, right? So let us see the status as of today, which is May 8th. First thing is ITCZ. ITCZ has still not moved much. It is still near the equator, which is shown by this yellow line. Okay. The reason it is not moving northward is because of the western disturbance that was seen in the north of India. And secondly, there is this system in southern hemisphere, which is not allowing the ITCZ to pinch off and move ahead, basically northward. Okay, so that's why kind of ITCZ has a now very slow motion, okay, or it is kind of stuck, we could say, close to the equator. Ocean SSTs are high, and that's the reason why the low pressure is forming. Okay, because if you see the ocean sea surface temperature, 30-31 is very common, and this is where it is expected to form near the Andaman Sea, and you can see temperatures are quite high, so that ocean atmospheric interaction will happen and a low pressure will form. And if you also look at the ocean SST anomaly, then there you can see that some warming has happened in this region. In the last video, there was some cooling scene, but slowly the Kelvin wave is, equatorial Kelvin wave has strengthened, and that's why there is some warming, and because of that warming, the low pressure is going to form. Okay, and that low pressure will form here. Okay, this is where the low pressure is expected to form, and you can see there is some organization that is happening. Okay, the clouds are kind of getting organized. Okay, so that low pressure will form. But what will happen to that, whether it will become a cyclone or not, is the question, right? So since MGO is not favorable, as you can see, the green line is the futuristic MGO, where so starting from 7th of May, what is the MGO movement, you can say. So since I have been telling that if the MGO is in this inner circle, then it's weak, and moreover, MGO is not in our Indian Ocean, right? It is going to come later on 12th or 13th, but even if it comes, and is going to be very weak. Both the models predict that, ECMWF and GFS, that MGO is going to be very weak. So it is not going to help in the intensification of this system. Okay, so we don't have to worry. And lastly, the wind shear, the vertical wind shear, which is the 850 to 200 HP anomaly between these two levels, the wind shear is quite high. You can see the red values, right? The wind shear is very high, so that will not allow the system to organize and form a cyclone. So the low pressure system will kind of disintegrate either in the sea, or it will maintain a low pressure and just move towards Bangladesh or Myanmar coast. That is what is expected. So final conclusions from today, looking at these dynamics, is that low pressure is likely to persist in Bay of Bengal. Cyclone formation is ruled out, at least that is my personal opinion. The reason is because low convective power, ITCZ is not favorable, it is stuck near the equator. And the wind shear is very high, upper level wind shear is very high, which will not allow the organization of the system into a cyclone. The system will maintain as a low pressure, and it will likely move towards Bangladesh or Myanmar or dissipate in the sea. There is no threat for any of the states, Tamil Nadu, Andhra, Odisha, West Bengal. And I am not expecting any rains from this system. There is not going to be any upper air circulation or anything. The system is either going to dissipate, or it will move towards Bangladesh or Myanmar. So please don't believe in any rumors about cyclones, and also request you not to blindly follow the model outputs. And I urge you to guys to follow the IMD website for any official updates. And they have also clearly said that for the next 5 to 6 days, there is no cyclone threat. Okay, so this is the status as of today. If there anything changes, I will update it on my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this, and please subscribe.